girls know you're driving with a tail light out?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No, we didn't know. But thank you for telling us.
Let me see your license and registration. Huh? Hey, where's your license?
Actually, I don't have my license with me.
You don't?
No.
You have a driver's license?
No.
You don't have it with you? Whose car is this?
Listen, this is our father's car. We don't have a license.
I met Terry's brother first at treatment. And then I went to a halfway house and I ended up in a storefront downtown. So Terry comes in. I don't even know how Terry knew I was there. I didn't even know Terry. But everybody knew Terry Olson.
Really?
And so, no. Terry came into my place.
Uh-huh.
And he says, "Hey." No. He says, get your shit together. Why are you wasting your life away? You know what? He was right.
So anyway, like I was saying, I got this new job and they sell like, you know, sex novelties and dildos and anal beads and Benoit balls and all that kind of stuff. And last night, the warehouse where they keep all the vibrators and everything got robbed.
Come on, sweetheart, eat some food.
No, I don't want to. I'm not hungry.
You said it was fun, so I'll eat some food. I eat some food.
No, you're interrupting me. Let me finish the story. Anyway, so like I was saying, the dildo warehouse got robbed and they figure it's an inside job.
Inside job. I guess you could say that.
Shut up, it's not funny. They called the detectives and they were like interviewing everybody at the store, you know, it was like a big deal. And of course, the detectives recognized me, which was like my luck at a new place. And my boss, you should have seen his face when the detectives knew me, you know, they were like, but it worked to my benefit because like they were like, oh, Pearl's a good kid, she don't steal, blah, blah, blah.
So now you just gotta unload $20,000 worth of vibrators.
Yeah, right, you silly. Ew. Right. Don't lick it so much.
You too, huh?
What?
You think I'm disgusting?
I didn't say that.
Is this good pot?
Oh, like you would know the difference.
I don't. That's why I'm asking.
Mm-hmm.
It is good.
I get you stoned if it's good.
It's okay.
It's just nice. It's not gonna. You're not gonna get wasted or anything.
Yeah.
Won't get you too high.
But you gotta inhale it though.
Messed up.
Oh, really?
Well, she doesn't inhale her cigarettes.
Get out of here.
You don't.
He's right, you don't.
So what?
He's the kind of kid to get his heart broken very easy. No?
Maybe, maybe not. Are you worried about that happening?
No, I'm just saying. He's the kind of kid that could happen to.
Can happen to anybody.
Yeah, but it can happen to him easy. He ain't been very far from home, you know what I mean?
I wonder if like Jack ever came in here and like wrote poems down when he was like drunk on napkins. I bet he did. You should write. You probably got a lot of stories.
We got a few.
Yeah, I bet you've been around the block a few times, eh?
A couple.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get another beer. You guys gonna hang? Where are you gonna go? Are you gonna just gonna hang out?
We'll be here when you get back.
Yeah, no.